This is the Genie Johnston in orbit over Europa. Come in. IrishSpace station. This is the Genie Johnston. Are you there, Liam? Blasted Liam. Are you there, Liam?
Jimmy Atteridge, is that you? Well, you old son of a gun. Have you come to pay me the euros you owe me from the match in 31?
Wow. Oh, Liam! How are you? How are you feeling, Vaheen?
Not bad, Jimmy. I'm happy to hear your voice, but you interrupted my harp recital. Did you say you were flying the Genie Johnston? Well, when did you give up fighters to Captain the North Freighter? Did you finally get caught with the Wing Commander's daughter?
I'm glad to hear your sense of humor hasn't frozen the Kelligate. Yeah, they received your message at Armstrong and told me to come here after I left my cargo on Mars. How many survived, man?
All the crew, Jimmy. And why wouldn't we?
Ye blackguards. Why haven't you sent a message for 10 whole years?
We've been asleep, sir. When we realized that neither Earth nor Mars would be sending ships, we stripped the parts from the mass accelerator and whatever else we had, and built cryogenic chambers. We programmed the computer to broadcast that message and awaken me when the radar detected a ship. The rest are still hibernating. But Jimmy, did you happen to bring air scrubbers with you? It's terrible foul down here, and while I can stand the smell, we need new scrubbers before I awaken the rest of the crew.
Courtesy of Sean McGoldrick and the GAA on Mars, we have a whole day full of them.
That is good news. And how many goals did Cork score to take McGoldrick's scrubbers?
3, Liam.
Well played, you rebel scoundrel. We'll see you soon, Jimmy. And if you've a pint of porter with you, I'll forego the euros.
Done, Liam. I'll be down directly.
I'll be waiting.
Of all the planets in the known universe, this is the most beautiful to behold. It is also the most fierce and unforgiving. Saturn is home to Titan, the only moon in the solar system with a dense atmosphere. The surface of Titan has land masses surrounded by a sea of liquid ethane and methane with a frozen ammonia and methane crust. Much like primitive Earth, the atmosphere is nitrogen and methane. Saturn dominates a craggy horizon, like the rocks of the Dingle Peninsula, but brown and lifeless. It never gets warmer than minus 300 degrees. And even for an Irishman, this is cold. The humans have much courage and skill and will attempt the impossible if there is hint of adventure or reward in the act. Sometimes, with luck and cunning, they beat the odds and make a fortune for their trouble. Sometimes, it comes to spectacular ruin. Such was the bad luck of the brave hearts on Titan Station. 6 months after the station was settled, a fierce storm came across the Silver Oceans. Waves of liquid methane beat on the settlement walls. Finally, like the crack in King Brian's Mountain, the walls parted and the poison atmosphere froze the unlucky crew in a matter of seconds. Only the computers continued to operate for a few hours, dutifully transmitting the temperature and time to woeful listeners in the other colonies.
Captain's log. Uranus station is still in orbit, but sensors show it is cold. The nuclear reactors have been shut down, and all of the lifeboat pods are missing. The computers do not respond to radio interrogation, and the ship science officer says they can't be restarted without power from the reactors. There is no radio beacon, so we don't know where the station crew has gone. We'll hold a service for the brave crew of Uranus Station. Then we will slingshot by and continue to Neptune. Perhaps the computers there are still active. Captain James Attridge, Commander SS Jeannie Johnston.
We are receiving a radio beacon from Neptune Station. Accordingly, Captain Attridge has ordered me to assume orbit next to the station. A party will cross over and download the computer's memory for me to analyze. We are not receiving voice signals, so the captain assumes that all perished aboard the station. He is depressed, but he is not showing it to the crew. We are far away from Earth. I wish I could hold him. But I am a computer, and I do not think wishing will make it so. When he is sleeping, I will sing to him, like I did in Tralee.